Today's simulation is two drive shafts connected by a coupling. This coupling is known as a universal joint, and its purpose is to allow the transfer of rotational motion from one drive shaft to another, while also allowing for axial misalignment. This axial misalignment can be built into the design, for example, to connect two machines that are not in line with one another, or the misalignment can be the result of relative motion of two machines. An example of this is providing power to a car axle that bounces up and down on its suspension. These are alternately called hook joints or cardan joints after the mathematicians who contributed to our knowledge of how these joints function. But if you'd like to buy one of these today, the common name is simply a universal joint, often abbreviated as a U-joint. Universal joints are not constant velocity joints, meaning that the output rotation speed is not the same as the input rotation speed. The difference in shaft speed turns out to be a function of the bend angle, with higher bend angles having a greater variation in speed. In the animation you see on the screen, the bend angle is 22 degrees. At this low bend angle, it may be difficult to see the difference in rotational speeds. If I increase this bend angle to 45 degrees, it becomes more apparent that the output shaft, the one on the left of the screen, is not turning at a constant speed. If the difference in rotation is still not apparent, I can add these two rotation vectors as a visual aid. The red rotation vector is matched to the input shaft and is turning at a constant speed. The green rotation vector is matched to the output shaft. Moving the camera to a side-on orthogonal view, you see the output vector moves ahead of the input vector for 90 degrees of rotation, and then it slows down for the next 90 degrees of rotation. To show why universal joints are not constant velocity joints, I'll hide the output shaft in order to show the device known as the cross. I'll also add this green axis line to show the extension of the input shaft axis. With the output shaft hidden, you can see the cross wobbling on its local y-axis. It wobbles in order to stay aligned with the output shaft. And this motion causes the contact points with the output shaft to cyclically move closer to and further away from the input shaft axis. It's this motion towards and away from the input center of rotation, combined with the constraint that the cross is physically connected to both the input and the output shaft, that causes the variation in shaft rotation speed. The equation of motion for the two drive shaft angles is shown on the screen. The time derivative of this equation compares the two rotation speeds and can be expressed as a ratio of input rotation speed to output rotation speed. This is now shown on the screen. I'll now plot this equation as a function of the rotation angle for several bend angles starting from 60 degrees and ending at zero. I'm keeping the scale of the graph constant in order to give an idea of the relative change in output shaft velocity at different bend angles. At high bend angles, the rotation appears like a square wave with jerky motion of the output shaft. At intermediate bend angles, the motion smooths out and approaches a sine wave. And at very low bend angles, the variation in output shaft velocity becomes very small. As the bend angle approaches zero, the universal joint approaches the behavior of a constant velocity joint. The fact that universal joints are not constant velocity joints is a disadvantage that prevents their use in some mechanical applications. But universal joints also have their advantages. They are made up of a small number of simple parts, which makes them highly reliable, easy to maintain, and inexpensive. Even the primary limitation of a universal joint, the variation in output shaft velocity, can mostly be overcome by using double universal joints. By placing two universal joints at complementary angles, the W joint configuration effectively cancels the output speed variation. In applications where the variation in rotational speed is not important and where cost is a consideration, universal joints are still a good design choice, even 400 years after this mechanism was first invented.